How the fuck did you just pop out of nowhere?
Bullets are a nasty business. The silver slug deformed and shredded on impact.
I'm about to say, like, what the fuck? Are you just randomly sitting
there? He'll
be
okay, though.
With the shirt on everything.
He'll be okay?
His internal organs are positively riddled. If I don't extract every single scrap of silver,
that was a game,
he's liable to suffer
real life
long-term toxicosis.
You get blasted.
Easy there. Try not to move.
Then you got somebody just sticking shit on you. Oh my god.
Pigby.
God damn.
We can't keep meeting this way, old boy. I figured I'd be done before you were conscious. But there's little I can do for the pain.
Swinehart, how bad is it?
Well, not the worst I've seen, but damn near it. I must say, you're testing even my skills here.
Please, Bigby, don't move it. Doctor.
God damn.
Look, I'm a bit engaged saving his life at the moment. But if the fractured extremity concerns him that much, he can set it himself.
I thought it was like watching a movie. Oh my god, I have to fucking do this shit? God damn it, bro. What the fuck? Oh my god, can you stop not stare at it, please? Just imagine me doing this shit in real life, bro. Dog, I feel like a bitch. Dog, I feel like that right in my wrist right now. I really do, dead ass.
Not bad.
Like, fix it.
That'll do, I suppose.
Like,
he's lucky to be alive.
Spam X,
and he won't be next time if he keeps going like this.
Move the bone the way it is.
He didn't listen to me before. Maybe he'll listen to you.
Maybe he's broken.
I don't know.
That and in my shoulder.
Well,
both hurt.
There are limits to what even I can do.
You know, I can't hear you.
Quiet. Just relax. Excuse me, Miss White, but perhaps it'd be better if you gave me a few minutes to finish with him.
I think I should stay, at least until he's out of the woods.
Believe me, Bigby couldn't be in better hands. And I need the space to work, so...
No,
stick around, all right? I don't know if I trust this guy.
Oh, please. I could do this with my optic nerve severed. We'll be down in a moment. Just please, give us the time.
All right, fuck off. Jackass.
Hey, Doc, how much longer?
Damn,
Colin,
the pig comes in.
Leave him be.
It's finished when it's finished.
Because I once watched a vet sew a turtle together in 10 minutes flat.
Colin, you're not even supposed to be here right now.
Oh, really? Where am I supposed to be? I'm here to take care of my friend.
With what? Your hooves?
Could I get some quiet in here?
Yes, that would be helpful.
Sorry.
There. All done.
Great.
This isn't a habit you should keep to. Having visits with me. And, well, this time. This time was no joke. Eat as many metal shellings as you see fit, but take just one more silver round near your heart, and the only place I'll be visiting you is the morgue.
Uh-oh. Yeah, that's it. You're done.
Miss White, he'll be fine for light duty, if he can figure out what that means.
He knows what it means. It's just been
no
an
action
unusual
this chapter.
Couple of days.
I know, but please, don't give him the excuse. His body will eventually give out. Take care of him. Please.
I will. He'll need rest, I assume?
Sleep, mostly. Just keep watch, and make sure he doesn't get into further altercations.
I don't need a babysitter. I can look after myself.
Clearly. Anyways, guard against, as they say. Miss White? Sheriff? Colin.
Swiney?
So, how do you, feel?
It's Bigby, Snow. He'll be okay. Hell, I've seen him take worse.
Not as good as can be expected, I think.
So, not well, then.
I'm glad you're not dead. You stopped breathing, you know, when you passed out or died, I guess. It kind of scared the hell out of me. I've never seen you like that. And when Swinehart arrived, you know him, he's never worried. And even he thought you were...
You were really worried about me?
Yeah, you were really fucked up, man. You look like when you take an action figure and bend its limbs the wrong way.
Colin...
I'm just saying, I was worried about him is all. The guy hasn't had a night's rest in days.
Well, I'll get some rest when this whole thing is done.
What whole thing? What's even happening out there? I mean, do you guys have like a plan or something? And who should I be asking? Should I be worried about the Crooked Man taking over? Or is Crane still the thing?
Snow's the boss. She'll know what's best for the community.
Thanks. The Crooked Man came out of the shadows for a reason. For him to attack us so blatantly like that. He either feels invincible or desperate.
Well, if those are my two options, I don't think I'd pick desperate.
What do you mean?
You traded Crane to save Bigby. I'm just saying, that's not exactly something you do when you're playing with house money.
So he called my bluff. It's not like I'm gonna let Bloody Mary just murder.
Yeah, thanks, Snow. For all that back there.
No problem.
Thanks? You're not pissed that Crane's flown the coop? Or that the Crooked Man thinks he's got Snow under his thumb?
We're all mad about it, Colin.
Yeah, of course I'm pissed.
Of course I'm pissed, but what's done is done.
Okay, okay.
All I care about right now is just what does the Crooked Man want out of this? I thought he was just a loan shark. But clearly, he's operating in other circles. It can't just be about Crane, right? Getting him out of town? Is this all about the murders? Crane can't be useful to him anymore. So what could this have to do with Faith and Lily? How long has this stuff been going on?
Crane was a puppet, and the Crooked Man worked the strings. This is all about control of Fabled Town.
But then what do prostitutes have to do with it? Lily? And Faith?
I don't know how it all works out yet, but...
Maybe Georgie, huh?
I know it does. Somehow.
The Crooked
just the boss of the place.
Declared war against us last night. At least that's what I thought when it happened. But now I see this war has been going on for years. We just haven't noticed it because our way of doing things is broken. We need to do things the right way.
What does that mean? The right way.
What do you think I mean?
I don't know, but it suspiciously sounds like your way.
Look, I know things haven't gone great recently, but we're still doing our best.
That's not good enough. So, starting now, we do everything cut and dried, by the book, straight as an arrow.
Pure as driven snow.
I'm not saying I'm the arbiter of...
Sure you're not.
This town has enough monsters. What happened last night, what you turned into, it can't happen again.
We need monsters to fight monsters.
Colin, if I really believed that we needed him to lose his flippin' mind at a moment's notice...
We were under attack, Snow. What did you expect me to do?
There are degrees.
Degrees? I only ever do what's necessary.
Really? Well, if that's the case... Please explain to Colin why tearing Dumb's throat out was necessary.
Bro, you try to kill me.
You can't let up until the fight is finished. He was still a threat, and that's all there is to it.
Basically.
Sure. Look, Bigby, I care about how this is done just as much as I care about it getting done.
So for that, you want to give him a handicap? Like the bad guys will worry if shit gets sloppy. Everybody wants Bigby to smile and shave and take a shower now and then. Hell, I'm practically the president of the Bigby Don't Be Such a Dick Club.
Well, at least someone understands. Thanks, Colin.
He'll get the job done. Just let him do it.
I'm going to let you do it, okay? It's just that now that I'm deputy mayor, I need your respect. And this situation has to end.
What situation?
All unglamored fables starting today have to go and stay at the farm.
Oh, give me a fucking break. Are you gonna let her talk to me like that?
It's been the rule for a reason, Colin. And Bigby knows it's for the best of the town.
That's not gonna happen.
Yes, it will.
No, it's an impossible rule to enforce, Snow. You really expect to round up every talking cat and raven in town?
Exactly.
There's not that many stragglers left. Except the one or two you make excuses for.
Looks like the pygmy's clamoring.
Wolf's residence.
That's rude.
Oh, Buffkin, what is it?
That's fucked up, I swear.
Okay, I'll let him know. Thanks. Guess who's waiting in your office right now? Narissa.
Narissa?
That broad from the Puddin' and Pie?
Yes. Apparently, she told Buffkin that she has something she needs to talk to you about. But that she'll only tell you. What do you think that could be?
Bigby's got an admirer. You always do well with the, disenfranchised.
I don't know. I don't know, maybe the fire.
I haven't the slightest.
Okay. I should get back to the business office. I've left Buffkin alone for too long taking
calls.
Manipulate
me, basically.
And I should probably change out of these clothes. Consider the discussion tabled, but not over. Let me know when you're done with Narissa.
Aye, aye, Captain. She's a piece of work. Hey, you're not really gonna send me to the farm, are you?
Nah, you staying.
I mean,
I'll make you stay.
She seemed real serious about it, but I can still hang out here.
Look, maybe a few will get sent up, but you're my friend, Colin. I wouldn't do that to you. Don't worry
about
it.
What if Snow,
thanks,
Snow don't like me? Exactly. Lucky Pond, okay, episode 4, in Sheep's Clothing. So go to Lucky Pond and what's gonna do?
Hi.
Oh, the pen.
Sheriff.
That's it.
Hi, Narissa.
The Wolf Among Us.
Yeah. Have a seat.
Are you okay? You didn't look good last night. I wasn't sure you'd be, you know, around.
Well, let's just say I've been better.
Huff and Puffs. Not many people smoke those.
What, sure is? That's the Newport and that's the Marlboro, I guess. Yeah, what brings
Thanks.
You here?
So what is it you wanted to talk to me about? I know what you did for me, sending me to the open arms. And I think you want to help me again.
There's not a lot that I can talk about. You know that.
So that spell Crane was trying to break. It's not just while you're at work, huh?
What I mean is, I don't want to waste your time, but I don't want you wasting your own time either.
Back in the dressing room, at the Pudding and Pie, I told you what I was looking for, and you found a way to tell me. You sent me to the open arms. Maybe that'll work again.
You can try. I just... Go ahead. It might work.
Yeah.
You're here because the crooked man just sent Crane to the bottom of my list of worries. And you have something you want to say about that, right?
These lips are sealed.
Mm-hmm. That's what I thought.
If I could answer you just like that, I wouldn't have had to make that appointment with you.
No, I guess not.
Sometimes we have to find our way through life on our own, grasping and fumbling in the dark. I used to have friends to help me find my way, but now they're gone.
I'm gonna start doing that.
And I don't know what to do.
But if I don't want to answer the question, these lips are sealed. And you'd be like, what?
Is these this lips making any are sense? Sealed.
Oh, shit.
I'm not sure how I can...
Trying to say something about Faith and Lily?
What I'm saying is friends matter. And I...
Oh, you want
I
to
don't
be a
have
friend?
Any left.
Is that what you're trying to say?
So I hope you're looking after yours. Are you? Look around you.
I guess it's my job to look out for people.
I don't know, but
not just my friends.
I'm sorry.
It's not I
could do this.
I should have put triangle.
I need you to know I want to help, but...
But your lips are sealed.
Best choice. Best choice ever.
I'm
exactly
sorry
exactly
if
my
I'm
that's exactly my
time.
Quote now.
I thought I knew how to say it.
Ribbons. Faith wore one too.
Do you like it? Do you?
I guess.
It is beautiful. That's why you can't tell me anything. It's the ribbon, isn't it?
Yeah, because they'll all be wearing it. I mean, take it out, and then the lips ain't gonna be sealed no more. They take the ribbon out. Is he gonna do it? Fuck it. Go ahead, let's go.
No! Lips are sealed!
Oh, exactly, exactly.
Just stay back. You
exactly.
can't.
That's what I thought.
Do that.
Slow down. It's all right. I'm not gonna do anything.
Please.
I guess if it's take out, she's
don't.
Dead. Maybe that's
okay.
Why Faith died.
I get it. So the ribbons, if you take them off.
Sorry. Just don't do that.
If anyone finds out I came here.
That's probably Snow.
Listen, Sheriff. Can you keep this conversation between us? I could be in a lot of trouble.
Nah,
I shouldn't be
Snow.
Talking to you.
I'm gonna have to tell Snow. She has to know about the ribbons.
If you have to, just don't tell anyone else.
Oh, you cheating on her?
Sorry,
oh.
I just need to talk to the sheriff for a moment. Please excuse us.
1 minute.
I might have a new lead for you, but I don't know how solid it is. Beauty and Beast called the office just now. They said they wanted to talk to you about something. I wonder if they've heard about Crane.
Thank you for listening, Sheriff. You should go on to your next business. I don't think you'll be wasting your time.
Wait, you don't have to go. That was... abrupt?
That's one way to send a message.
What did she tell you? I didn't mean to rush her out. Did you get anything from her?
She told me enough. I think she told both of us with the way she just left.
Okay, then. Good work.
So,
about Beauty and Beast, do you think there's something to it? Is this the right place to look? What could they know about the Crooked Man? Or do you think they just heard about last night, and they're scared about what's been going on?
Beauty told me she had to take out a loan from the Crooked Man. Seems like a pretty bad deal.
I can only imagine what they're thinking now. We need to solve this before something else happens. Who knows what? I have other matters to attend to.
Okay. Once upon a time.